Hello, and welcome to our presentation for the CNSI Nanovation Competition at UCLA. Our product is called the AmaZng Hydrogel. This is an innovative wound treatment combining nanotechnology, 3D scanning, and bioprinting for targeted wound care.
Our team is made up of four sophomores from Granada Hills Charter High School.
Our science experts consist of Sarah Ali
and Trishudev Chaudhary.
And our financial experts are Sejin Choi
and Kaylin Moranin.
While current wound treatment products on the market are effective, many brands focus strictly on holistic wound healing and do not address larger concerns for patients. Examples of this include increased pain due to frequent dressing changes and the potential for prolonged pain and discomfort due to secondary infection.
Our product encompasses wound treatment in the form of a custom-fit bioprinted hydrogel embedded with silver and zinc nanoparticles. First, a 3D scanner scans the targeted area of the body to account for the exact wound dimensions. The connected bioprinter will take in this data, designing tailored dressings for each wound type.
Hydrogel-based wound care provides a suitable level of moisture to promote healing and a flexible medium that can be easily removed or changed. First, our product uses a combination of silver and zinc oxide nanoparticles, which have naturally occurring antibacterial, antifungal, and antimicrobial properties and act in preventing infection.
Next, we address antibiotic resistance by eliminating the use of antibiotics. With a combination of silver and zinc nanoparticles, our product can prevent infection more effectively compared to current antibiotic-embedded treatment designs. The final advantage includes the 3D scanning aspect. This unique component allows us to make a custom-fit wound dressing. The custom fit would minimize material waste and the pain inflicted due to ill-fitted dressings. The minimization of waste from our product also reduces production costs and resources.
Currently, there are many products that allow for the inclusion of nanoparticles in hydrogel-based wound dressings. With this in mind, our product presents a feasible method for targeted wound care using nanoparticles and bioprinting.
We performed extensive research in the field of wound care, creating our socially distanced survey in order to gather primary data from medical professionals who deal with wound treatments. Questions address topics like frequency of wound dressing changes, as well as what are the current uses and benefits of nanoparticles in varying practices.
Our data informs on the awareness of the benefits of nanoparticle use among medical professions. The primary data showed that 66.7% of wound dressings are changed 1 to 4 times per day, meaning that dressing changes not only take up more time, but also use more materials.
Approximately 6.5 million people experience chronic wounds, which often leads to a problematic and long-term healing process. With regards to cost, $25 billion are spent treating chronic wounds annually. Currently, wound care products total $15.3 billion, and as the market expands, these prices are climbing.
This, however, does not translate to patient expense, where care for chronic wounds can cost an upward of $4,000 per patient. Our goal is to be able to lower this average cost by reducing materials used while simultaneously reducing patient recovery time.
We hope to gain a 12.1% profit margin, with the first year earning $45,000. Each unit includes the bioprinter and basic resources, which would cost about $500 per unit.
In this table, you can appreciate the middle column, which indicates shipping costs to 25, 50, and 100 hospitals and practices. Our asking amount is slightly larger to prioritize customer service and need. We plan to patent the novelty of our combined 3D scanning and printing system. While patents exist for nanoparticle embedded hydrogels, these are limited to include only one type. Our product not only incorporates both silver and zinc nanoparticles, but also utilizes a 3D scanner and bioprinter.
We plan to conduct a larger market survey, prototyping and optimizing the product. In the first year of manufacturing and sales, we plan to sell a minimum of 25 units plus 125 kits between 25 hospitals. Through the second year, we will expand to additional hospitals and private practices. In the third year, we will disperse more units and collect feedback to improve the process.
These are the sources we used in our presentation.
We would like to say a special thank you to everyone who supported us with this project, including our teacher, Ms. Chips, our UCLA mentors, and medical professionals who responded to our survey and provided insight to this field.
And a special thanks to CNSI for allowing us to continue in this competition in light of COVID-19 and these uncertain times.